All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Stephen Harpur, the CEO of Progressive Planet. And Stephen, it's good to have you back. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you, Steve.
Really interesting news release out today talking about some things that's happening on your Heffley Creek project and property. Why don't you sort of take us back a little bit? There had been some historical work done on this before you actually took over that property. Is that correct?
That's correct. So our interest in this property was due to the fact that Lafarge had actually in 1998 and 1999 done significant exploration work, including 10 shallow drill holes that defined some aluminosilicate reserves. And we've never ever announced those reserves. We didn't do the work ourselves, but we have written documentation. We have all the drill hole data, and we have their internal reserve calculations, and specifically the mineralization that's of the most value is the high alumina content aluminosilicates. And when we signed the option to earn 100% interest in this property, the vendor wanted us to do exploration work because he felt there were metals on the property as well. And while our primary interest was the aluminosilicates, we very quickly discovered anomalous nickel over a significant strike length. And in this news release, we now have an 800 meter strike length. But we've also announced in this latest news, very significant levels of chromium in the bedrock, in the grab samples from the bedrock. And this is occurring with the nickel.
So obviously we know that the importance of nickel as far as we've heard of electric vehicles and all that kind of stuff. Tell me about chromium and why that's so important.
Well, chromium is, it's a major component of stainless steel. So there's a very robust market for it. And so stainless steel contains a minimum of 10.5% chromium. What we discovered in this this strike area was anomalous chromium. And in many cases, the elevated chromium and the elevated nickel are in the same rock. And we actually had chromium levels that were almost double our highest nickel. So our highest nickel in bedrock has been 0.26%. And we got 0.45% chromium in the bedrock, which we reported in this latest round of assays.
So now, obviously, in this news release, you talked about doing some work on as far as grab samples and rock samples and things like that. You've taken to the lab, and that's allowed you to extend this particular area. So with the historic data and the stuff you've done now, what does that lead you to take the next steps? What are they going to be come 2021?
So we only have about 2 weeks, 3 weeks maximum where we can safely continue to sample bedrock, sample outcrops. We've already had snowfall once. It's melted. We actually have crews out today sampling. But for the rest of this year, the work we will do through to Christmas will be metallurgical work, looking at the ability to extract the nickel, extract the chromium. We're also waiting on some precious metal assays, and we'll see where those come in. And then the really significant unknown for us right now is whether we have anomalous nickel and anomalous chromium in the 500 meter length between the 800 meter strike to the north, where we define this in our maps. And then to the south, we have anomalous nickel as well. And there's a 500 meter in between where we have very little outcrop. So in the spring of 2021, we will seek approval to mechanically excavate so that we can expose outcrop and attempt to extend the strike to significantly over 1 kilometer from the 800 meter strike length we've exposed right now.
Stephen, is there any plans to drill in 2021?
We would we wish to drill in 2021, subject to receiving a permit to do so. We're very excited because there is a elevation difference from the lowest part of the strike area to the highest of about 140 to 160 meters. So we already have a three-dimensional view of mineralization based on this elevation difference. So absolutely, it will be our goal to put some drill holes in to attempt to get a better three-dimensional idea of how big this ore body is.
All right, Stephen, well, we look forward to hearing more about that come 2021. Great to see you again. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.
All right, there's Stephen Harpur, the CEO of Progressive Planet.